get a picture. Love you with my heart, but it ain't need me to forget you. When you go against the grain where I'm from, they just kill you. All these niggas screaming, not familiar, not familiar. How you a killer with some feelings? Catch him on a block, hit a nigga in his.
What's up, what's up? Love and loyalty, it's your boy Juice O'Summer.
It's your boy Clutch, man. What it do?
We got some guests with us today. We're gonna let them introduce themselves.
What up with y'all? Y'all, this D, True Vision, that's what they usually know. It's so safe vibes.
It's Cope, Deshaun Cooper, True Vision, basketball player, professional. I do this.
Let's get it. First question we ask every guest, y'all, if y'all had to choose between love or loyalty, what would y'all pick?
I say loyalty. Why? And the reason I would say loyalty is because love can only get you so far. Loyalty, you can take that to the end. Like it don't end. I feel like wherever you go, loyalty can lead to love. So at that point, I take loyalty over love, for sure.
I'm gonna go the same way. I'm gonna go loyalty also, because it just sounds like the people you need to be with, the people that's loyal to.
What about y'all?
I tell everybody, it's loyalty. Loyalty over everything.
Yeah.
Somebody asked me the other day, like, because I always say I'd rather be happy and all that shit and I won't trust. Somebody legit hit me with some crazy shit, say, would you sacrifice your happiness for trust? I'm like, shit.
Shit.
For real, yeah.
I don't think
you can be happy
without, like, trust.
I don't think you can, but, like I say, to answer that question, I had to say, yeah.
Happy. I can't be happy if you don't trust me, but I'm always thinking something in the back of my head.
But so that's right. Why I said to answer that question, I had to say, yeah. You want to, you have the same way we just asked that, happiness or trust. True, like I said, a lot of dudes don't really give a fuck about being completely happy because they're not completely happy. So it's like, you're going to be 100, like, yeah, trust is, I put that for everything, trust and loyalty.
I don't know if there's such thing as being completely happy.
I think it's a two-way street. I want to be happy too, though, like, no matter what's going on.
I feel like everybody want to be happy. But like when I say this shit, they, everybody say that I'm sexist, but I speak for dudes type shit because I talk to niggas that I know and everything, and there's not enough niggas that I know that's legit completely happy. Like, it's to the point where, like I said on the episode before, I feel like the girls feel like we're happy when we taking care of them. Like, to the point, yo, gig and walk in the house, you gonna legit, man, what's up with you? You can feel our energy.
Yeah.
Man, you good? What's wrong? Like, you gonna try to do whatever you can, usually, to, you know, make sure you can try to fix it if you can. I just heard something earlier. It's like, man, if your girl go to sleep angry or upset, that's on you. Even if you ain't the reason that she's upset. So that's on you.
Yeah, you supposed to care.
Yeah. But once again, shit, if a nigga go to sleep angry or whatever, go sleep on that couch.
Yeah, that's because we gonna take on all the problems. The man take on all the problems behind whatever's going on. I take on whatever it's going to be. Like, I take on your problems, the kid problems, and my problems. But then at the end of the day, it's, you be worried about, like, you and the kids, and you know what I'm saying? Right. And you kind of get forgot about.
True.
And that's why I said the happiness shit for dudes, it gets swept under the rug. And it shouldn't, but it do. Like, a lot of females ain't going to never really admit that shit and just chunk it up. But, hey, we know the truth.
Shit. You're an artist. Yeah. Are you good at it?
The champ is here. What's up, man?
No, they did that.
Talk that shit.
Y'all won the pro.
They did that.
So look, did y'all see the episode we had with BJ and Pep?
I toned in. Yeah,
so we talked about the top five in the city, and I remember, like, talking to them off camera. They couldn't name you. They said because you an overseas player.
Yeah.
So they didn't want to name no G League, no overseas. They want to name basically guys that hooping in, like, the Show Me's, the St. Vincent's, all them type of leagues consistently.
Mm-hmm. But I want to ask y'all the same question, but minus the NBA. You can say G League, overseas, whatever, all that.
Especially after watching that program, because we went to the game and watched that shit, and, man, we got a lot of people that need to get the hell out of St. Louis.
Yeah,
that's supposed to be gone.
So what would be your top five?
Not in the NBA.
Not in the NBA.
And around St. Louis.
St. Louis.
To be for real, I don't even dig into that for real. I call myself the underground king. I don't even look at that top five shit. I know I created my route, and I went my route, and I stuck to it. That's what I pride myself most on. So when everybody be talking about these rankings and who did what, it ain't really about comparing each other. It's about what they did when they went there. You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody had their own route. It's about who maximized their ability to the maximum that they could do it. How many people did that? Like, how many people can you say went off to college, got better, took over their college scene? How many people you can say went to high school, got better, took over their high school scene, went pros, took over their shit? How many people you can say did that? Not too many people you can say, but when you look at the game and all these skills and the videos, yeah, you can say your top five. But when you talk about the actual resume, you gotta actually go into details and actually break that shit down. So a lot of people, they break their top five down just off what they see. I'm gonna break my top five down off what I, you know, see, what you did, what I heard, how are you, like, you know what I'm saying, what you doing in life. And that's just what I look at it as.
And it's crazy, because even like with what you said, that shit make perfect sense. But I'm just thinking back to, I'm trying to remember myself of they top fives.
Yeah.
Man, they top fives played in the game. Like, y'all had like four on y'all team. And
that's what I'm saying.
It was
like,
crazy shit. Like, who they say? Big Marco,
like,
Tay-Tay, Munson.
They played.
Pelp.
Stop.
Stop
wasn't in there?
No, because they say he was G League overseas.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, it's just opinion based, and it ain't based off, you know, actual facts. They just saying what they think and what they seen them do against that person. What this person did in high school their whole career. 4 years. What this person did in college for 4 years. What this person did when they went pro. What this person doing in pro and what do they do in all these leagues that they playing? Then you can say what your top five. But if you just going off around St. Louis, then that ain't really no top five for real. Mm-hmm. You gotta consider everybody who left this motherfucker. You gotta consider all of them.
It's a lot of
that's why I say I wanna know minus the NBA. I wanna know minus the NBA. Like,
it's a lot of killers.
Yeah, for sure. It's a lot. Like, it's really a lot. And I just salute people for what they're doing and how they're doing it. I ain't really trying to party. So, like, I just salute them, shit. Because I know my route I had to take, shit. Everybody tried to compare me to this and that and doing this. I'm like, fuck it. I got to focus on myself.
I mean, Ladell said, if you were 6'4", 6'3", you'd be in the league.
For sure.
I swear to God, Ladell told me that.
If I was 6 anything, I'd be in the league. That's just how I go, though. But I always had to face that stigma of, you know, 5'7", 5'6", or whatever you wanted to call me. And I'm still facing it to this day. Even though I'm pro, I'm still facing the same shit. You 5'7", I can find somebody who's 6'3". I mean, it is what it is, but the love of the game is what drove me here. So I ain't do it to, you know, be compared to the greatest or whatever. If my resume say that, then that's what the fuck I did. Like, that's just who I am. But I did this for the love, so.
What about you, Mr. True Vision? That's your thing, right? Your organization.
That's his thing.
That's ours. I'm the creator. I created True Vision. I was the one who created it. This man right here is the one who got it off the ground for me. Cause I'm never hurt. He's the face.
Yeah, like, my man came home, like, hey, D, this is what your vision is. This is what it look like. I'm like, man, this ain't
I ain't gonna let y'all start this. Watch this.
But I sit back and I
it happened just like that. Like, Coop Wayne did it. Watch this. Yeah. He's been on the cracking and everything.
Exactly. So what is it? Is it just a brand or is it like it's a training ship?
We're a mentorship group. So basically, I went to school for physical education. I wanted to be in schools but not work for the schools. So I created this nonprofit organization. So, like, in college, we had GMs that look out for the college athletes, like, make sure their grades right, make sure all these things right. And I wanted to create this, you know, mentorship group full of pros and actual former athletes that we can go back to high schools and do the same thing. Instead of it just being at the college level, now it's at the high school level for black, you know, for inner city black kids. So now we helping each other out. So we basically giving them a cheat sheet so when they go to college, ain't no coming back. You already ready. You already been going through college workouts for 4 years in high school. So now when you get off into that, it ain't no coming back. It ain't no surprises, ain't no walking back, ain't none of that. It's you standing, you going forward. You was already prepared.
What was your mindset behind that? Like, what sparked that idea in your head? Just like, okay, this is my plan. This
because
is what
when I was coming out of college, like having to face that stigma of always being 5'7", not knowing how to get a scholarship. Like, I played for the Eagles and I did all that, but it was still that, what do I need to do to make it? You get what I'm saying? Like,
it's limited spots.
Yeah, like, so how is it in college? Like, I always had that question, like, how is it in college? You get what I'm saying? But now none of our kids ask that because they know. They know what it's like to be in the pros now. They know what it's like to be in college already before they even get there because they around it. So I wanted to make sure that these kids didn't have that question, had that wondering what it's like to do what. You already gonna know. You wanna know what it's like to be a pro? Well, come work out with us. Come do this.
This is just like a local thing? Because you said you be out of town a lot.
No, it's like a family thing. Like, it's just, you know, we all over the world. Man.
Yeah,
like,
it ain't local at all.
We all over the world, bro. It's just how you drawn to the energy. Like, it's people that we just see out. We'll be walking in the group and we'll just see out. Hey, we seen y'all around. We seen y'all a month ago. How we get down? And we like, hey, why you see us a month ago? Like, it's just people just drawn to that energy of how we carry ourselves and what we represent. And that's how we just created it. And that's how we go about it.
That's my son. He just doing it. I talk on Rodeo in the Maybach. They think that that's Rick Ross. Wanna fuck me? She a bro. Sorry, boo, that's a big hell now. Nah. Wanna sneak this? It's cool though. That's your let's not get caught. Got 50, 30 switches every pole. He did. Brand new money, blue nose falling out my clothes. He did. This my.
Oh yeah, and it's a lot in between, y'all. Like, you know, sponsored football teams, basketball teams, gave back to the community. Like, it's a whole lot in between. We got a building we trying to fix up. Like, it's a whole lot. We got some of the best kid teams in the world, man. Like, it's
a
lot.
We got ranked with third grade team.
No, second, third.
They from
here? Yeah.
Like Bobby was saying.
Yeah.
Dude. Like that team ranked nice.
Yeah, man, like that.
But that's the crazy thing, like, the True Vision Basketball, like, that just came about. Like, we didn't go into it planning for none of this to happen. Like, all this is just coming to us.
Organic.
You get what I'm saying? So we just taking it as it's rolling out. So we just like, all right, we got enough kids now to start an organization. Because I told them from the jump, like, that wasn't my vision. If that's y'all vision, go right ahead. You get what I'm saying? But that's what True Vision is about. Following your passion, following your dream, and sticking to it. And that's what I want everybody to do. So if you with us and you know you got a vision, go with it. I ain't finna be the one to knock you.
No matter what sport you're playing.
You get what I'm saying?
Hell yeah, that's what's up. Because like I said, I feel like down here in St. Louis, I just had a talk to my cousin the other day. He was saying St. Louis is a hating city and all that. And I really don't feel like it is. I feel like shit. Man, if you from down here and you doing everything right, people gonna fuck with you. They going legit. Like you just said, gravitate towards the good. Yeah. You might think it's bad, the news might say all this bullshit, but once again, if you down here, you been down here, man, you doing what you supposed to do. Man, I swear to God, you gravitate towards good people.
But it come with it though, y'all. Like be saying all our life, you ain't got no haters, you ain't popping. You gonna get haters no matter what you doing.
What's crazy, everywhere you go, they love St. Louis. Everywhere you go, they love St. Louis. I ain't never been on where people be like, man, you from St. Louis.
They say it's a thing amongst St. Louis itself, like to the point where, like you just said, you can leave from St. Louis, go to LA, they gonna love you.
Mm-hmm.
You can legit leave from this house right now and go a couple streets over, they gonna hate you now, y'all. Type shit. But once again, when it comes down to certain things like this, like I say, just y'all whole brand, everything about it, I haven't heard one bad thing about it. Like, I ain't gonna lie to you, like, not one.
That's right.
Like, at all. It's to the point where, shit, like, he told me about the shit with the kids. I thought it was like training. Like I say, shit like that. That's what I thought it was. He told me about the shit with the kids. I'm like, all right, yeah, that's deep. Because I mean, when Pep talked to us about his school and shit, I'm like, just to hear that shit, I'm like, man, these are regular dudes from St. Louis.
Yeah.
They're legit giving back. Like I said, don't get the promotion. They ain't looking for clout. Y'all ain't on the internet. This is what I'm doing for the city. Y'all just doing the shit.
And they show you that the city ain't bad like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, because you ask me, the people I be around is 100. So how can I say the city bad or be scandalous like this? Is the people I'm around, you know what I'm saying, every day. Now you're going to have haters and all that. They come along with the world. That's in every city, you know what I'm saying? Right. So that shit just be crazy how people just water down our name like that or water down the city like that.
Yeah. But now then a lot of people, they'll try to create friction between us, you know, because they don't know who ran what. Like some people think it's his brand. But that's how he rep it. Like, and it is his brand. He own a percentage of it. Like, that's the thing. People don't know about it. We not out here throwing it out there. But he walking around like he own it, and that's what he's supposed to do, because he do. And if people think he do, I'm not finna be wondering, he don't. No, he do. You get what I'm saying? He represent, he putting me on, he putting us on. Why would I knock him for doing something for the brand? You get what I'm saying?
And I be and doing that's the what same a lot thing, of people like, think. Make his way. Like, I tell people, oh, hey, tuck me in right here, man.
Nah, they think and they try to create that friction, but it's all love. I'm supporting him just as much as he's supporting me. Like, it's a team, and that's what we're about.
So, dude, you got a top five, though?
It's opinions, though.
It's everybody's opinion.
Yeah, I got a top five. I can say I got a top five. But it's opinions, man. My top five. Do G League count or they don't count either?
Like if they play in the G League. You go
G League.
My top five. Stock in there for sure. Mm-hmm. It's like, how can you not put him in there, man? Like, if you going off of what he's saying, like the resume, what he did at this school, I gotta go Coop, man. Coop in there. I'm sorry, this personal, it's just my guy. I'm gonna throw Kenny Man in there too, y'all. Kenny Man in there, in his prime. Stock, Coop.
I'm here back in the day.
Man, his prime.
Top five.
Lil Brian. What's the name his top five? I never heard of Big Marco.
Yeah.
I think he named the top five, and I watched him, like I said, the shit on with the Pepsi on TV. In the pro-amp, man, that nigga is legit.
Big Marco, one of the best bigs right now. I got it. How do you not go there? Right now, he best big out.
Is dude from St. Louis, the dude y'all played against the pro-amp, the white boy, the center, he was going.
He tough, too. I don't know. I don't know where he's from.
Jacob. I think he's from around here.
TJ told me about, like, man, look, dude right there, I swear, he can go for 25 whenever he want. He can shoot back to the basket. I'm like, I don't see it.
Nice.
Then he turned up. I'm like, all right. But, you know, dude, Big Marco legit. Like, yeah.
Yeah, sure, I put legit. Marco in there, and then the five is open. Like, I don't really know too many locked in bigs around here that's got it in.
And a lot of people, because we asked, before we even did the episode, we asked hella people around the city, like, man, just what's your top five? And everybody legit was giving us the same four people. Yeah. Nobody came forward to shit. What the, Munson, Tay-Tay, Hives.
They in that category, like, they in that, they got their own category too, man. Like, they in that own, they on their own little category too. Because if you talking, like, you know, all the leagues and all that, that's who be running all the leagues and all that. That's who be doing.
See, the thing about that is it really running leagues if all of them are on the same team?
Is it different? Because you still got to suit up and play basketball.
Yeah,
no matter what. It's hard to suit up and play against an all-star team. Like a regular team, they go suit up as an all-star team.
Because if you put that, if you name them four, and then we come back in the summer and you try to put that four up against another four, you, no.
It won't
work. That four won't work.
I think they can be beat.
That's what I'm saying. Like, that four won't work. Like, that's a nice-ass four.
Yeah.
But that four won't work.
BJ came on here and said he the best. Oh, BJ and Pep said BJ the best one-on-one player ever in St. Louis.
He could be.
That's a pain.
He could be. But I'm going to tell you this now. I'm the underground king, or whatever you want to call it. I'm the underground king. Y'all can take that 1, 4, 2, 3, whoever the top five. I'm the underground king. I take that. You get what I'm saying? Y'all can have mainstream. But underground, I'm running this. Can't nobody compare nothing to me, ever. Check my resume. You can check it. We can go all the way back, man, to the little leagues when I was 2 or 3. We can go all the way back. Like, dead ass. But that underground shit, I'm the underground king, period.
All right, so this is a question I asked people at the program before. From the city, just if you had to choose an area, neighborhood, where do you think the best hoopers come from? See, this thing I ask niggas, everybody say Wellston.
No, Janice. They in there because if you going off pros,
you got pros, to NBA, even they, back in the day type.
Hey, do y'all know a lot of people from Janice? Kelly Thames, Ed Glass, Jerome Murray, Deshaun Cooper, Courtney Stocker, Brandon Holland.
So what are we going off of,
bro?
If we going off of
Darren Brooks,
NBA,
all these Darren Brooks
and Normandy.
That's the same area. Normandy, Wellston, the same area. But NBA, they got the most.
Who, Wellston?
City, Wellston, Brad, Jason, City. That's crazy.
Brad, Pat and Ben, like, Wellston.
All this connected.
Those two guys, I feel like, that don't get enough respect down here, though.
Just Pat and Ben?
Yep.
Yeah, they don't.
That's Hoopers, like, they don't. And that's just
they don't, for sure.
From the city, and I feel like both of them niggas legit.
Especially Pat, though, because nobody expected him to do that. Like, Like, nobody expected him.
That's tough. Three of
like,
them things.
The way that he did it and how Switched he did it, you another. Gotta respect it the way he did it.
For sure. Man, that's what I told people. I said, man, I ain't gonna let him play. I feel like they
Switched
teams.
I feel
like they played him.
He actually played.
But I feel like he was out of position and still played. When KD got hurt that year, they had him starting at the three. Look past the one, for real. Anybody that really watched him play, like, that nigga legit. He can do He a Sean Livingston to me. That's who we remind me of.
Yeah, but the Warriors got them guys. They ain't taking their spots.
I'm here. They ain't going to put them there, but you know what I'm saying? For
he
him,
ain't come, he ain't
you
taking
understand, they
spot,
still had Iggy. Dude. They still had other guys that could have started at the three. They still chose to put him there at
the
start.
He sat down. Like, you could put him at the three. He is 6'7".
Yeah.
That's what he played.
But that's why I feel like he deserved it. Like, a lot of people talk shit. You see the silly ass memes and all that bullshit, but I'm a nigga, like I said, I'm a respect. Just flat the fuck out, man. That nigga played. That nigga got three of them things.
That's what I'm saying. And if you make it to that level to where you can get a meme made of you, shit. What you complaining about? Like,
even like how people in the city don't even talk about Ben right away. Shit. Like Ben say, man, he been in the league for 10 years. He a vet.
He is,
though. He say, man, y'all might not feel like he doing the shit. He ain't like Jason going out there dropping 30, 40. But once again, he's still getting paid every year.
Playing his role.
Playing his role.
It's going to take him to drop 30.
People need to focus on, bro. They said that it's only 5,000 people who ever made the NBA in the world. Like, and Ben is one of them 5,000 people. Like, that's legit. Like, you a legit certified basketball player.
Man.
That mean, you top 5,000 in the world. How many people have been in the world play basketball? Like, and he certified top 5,000, like, in the best league in the world. How can you hate on it? Like, you can't. And we here trying to hate on it. Like, you can't. Shit, I ain't in that 5,000. My bracket probably 100,000. I ain't 5,000 to limit it down to 5,000. That's tough, bro.
Being in 100,000
bracket. Like I said, you gotta look at it. Like I talked to my nigga Idea, I'm just talking to him about everything. You gotta look at like Ben, whole little thing. Like, nigga, T Rob came out right before him. T Rob went what, number two?
Thomas Rob.
Bro, he was in the league for what, 2 years? It's people that went above Ben, before Ben, plus Ben, them guys, they out the league. So once again, that man doing
picks.
Something. He's legit doing something.
Number one picks, nigga.
And then to be from here and to go there. Like, bro, like, come on now. And then to be from Wellston and to go there. Like,
man.
Bro, you ain't got nothing to do but respect. You can't compare that to nothing.
And you still want it. Like, you still want it in the NBA. Like, teams still are looking for it.
Exactly.
I feel like the city needs to, like, from the show me pages to everything else in the city, motherfuckers most definitely need to show. Shit, both of them guys are like the respect that they deserve for real. Cause man,
there's a lot of talent in St. Louis that go hunt. You know what I'm saying?
David Lee, all them type of guys are legit from the city, and they legit are pros.
Not really.
You gotta respect that.
There's a lot of kids coming up that's probably finna be pros from St. Louis.
It's different.
Nah,
why we speaking to us though? Shout out the mayor though, man. He with us too though, man. He helped with the basketball, all everything you see us doing. He be helping us do that too. And he a coach with the kids as well. So and shout out to him too.
Coach L.
I say, like you said, there's a lot of kids about to come out the city. I would say that shit in a couple years, they can see St. Louis taking over, have more league players than Chicago.
I can see that.
It's great, man. It's coming.
Y'all still tuning in high school. Yo, what's some kids y'all know that's coming up? Or y'all think this? Next up.
Man, who I'm watching right now, who caught my eye this past weekend was the little point guard from CBC. What's his name, dog? I'm not gonna find his name. But the little point guard, nice, man.
I think he went to Salu last year. Did he just transfer from that little point guard?
I'm gonna go to sleep.
I think he supposed to play the prime with y'all. The little guard, like, lead the college in assists.
Oh, Yuri.
He in college.
Nah, he
didn't go to the draft.
No, he didn't go. They overseas right now, actually. They SLU overseas. He went back to SLU. So they're SLU. They overseas right now, killing shit.
Think he can go?
Yeah. Oh, his name Anthony Goss.
In the country, in the city.
Point guard from CBC, Anthony Goss.
Yeah, and I'm going to go with Darion, man. 6'8".
He's a beer, though.
Yeah, but he's still in high school. He's from St. Louis.
Where you from?
He's from here.
Went to Riverview. And then went home school and it was up.
Where you going to school at though? Prep schools?
I can't forget the name.
I'm
feel like telling us you got to be groomed to go to the NBA. So that's the difference. Like that's what I'm telling. Like the difference is like being groomed. Like you know what I'm saying, being prepared to actually go to the NBA. Like you might be a nigga next to you that's more talented than you, but he got the right connections. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly. All that play a part.
And you say y'all whole program basically teach kids, get kids prepared for that.
Yeah. That's exactly what we do, right? We can use them for example. Why not that man go back to Genie's and walk the same streets these kids was walking, talk to the same teachers these kids talk to. It's just giving back in its purest form, for real. Like, he walked the same streets. They ain't got no buses, so.
Yeah,
had the same conversation, same rides. All this the same thing.
And then to show you that it worked, we took one summer and we worked the whole summer with Jenny's program. And they went to state that year. And they ain't been to state and I don't know how long before that year. But we worked out with them that whole summer and they ended up going to state that year.
Well,
and they ain't been back to state since.
Have Jenny's ever won state?
No.
Can't say they're number one. They go to Western and Western won state. But Western won state.
They're gonna like that.
How's it go? That was a good one though.
Like I said, there's a lot of people down here in the city, and that's why we even started the podcast for real, just to really just get the knowledge of everybody in St. Louis. Just we got a lot of shit down here that we can help everybody from. Like I said, just the knowledge, like I say, sports, everything. Like a bunch of young people, a bunch of us shit grew up different ways where, man, we seen all the bullshit. We've been through a lot of crazy shit. So like you said, why wouldn't we give back? Why wouldn't we legit talk about the shit we can talk about, help out if we can help out? Like, and that's why we started this shit. So like I said, when we send you out the program, I'm like, man, look, go holler at bro. Like, I know you know bro, tell him what's up the podcast. Yeah. Instantly, y'all said, yeah, like no faking. God,
man, we go back, though. We go back, like, I'm like outside of basketball, we go back.
Man. And that's all, like, and that's something, like, I really, like, I believe in, like, the networking shit. Like, man, if St. Louis, like, that's why I say it's not a hating thing. If St. Louis learn how to legit network, man, we got like everything we got crazy. In the
like
city.
Like the shit y'all doing and Pep them doing, they're just preparing kids, man.
That's so it's hard.
Like Pep said, you gotta straight have like a job. I mean, not a job, you have to have a business
before you leave.
Yeah, before you leave your school, man, that's so big. Like getting them kids prepared for everything like that, man.
That's what I said. That shit good though.
And now we got kids who came up under our brand with their own brand.
That's how it's supposed to be.
And that's exactly how it's supposed to be. Like I said, we ain't trying to tame you. You want to create your... Stick to your vision. Do what you got to do.
But they say...
That's how we support them, bro.
They say Atlanta going down. They say St. Louis legit can be the next Atlanta. If motherfuckers do everything right. If people learn how to network, communicate, kill all the bullshit.
People like y'all. It's the ground. Yeah. It's the ground for all that. Y'all setting the foundation for all this. So that's like big ups for y'all on there too, though.
It's up for sure, y'all.
Like I say, man, we're going to end it like this. Like I say, man, thank y'all for coming and showing the world, showing the city, like, legit, everything, teaching me.
Appreciate y'all.
Y'all say y'all ain't ducking no smoke, huh?
No. Not at all.
All ages, though. First grade up. Come on.
First grade all the way up to grown men. You
come
hear me?
With it, y'all.
We finna take over 30 and over next. You know, this next. That's the next thing we gotta get.
TJ said they winning that every year.
First grade up, come with it.
See, he was 25. He cheated that shit. Man, this love of loyalty to the podcast, y'all.
Nah,
fuck with us. Y'all know what it is.
This is your new family. Do you accept? I do.